First of all, Control plus 1. Remember, number pad keys are not worked with these shortcuts, so we have to use the number row. So first shortcut is Control plus 1. Here I'm going to press Control plus 1. This Control plus 1 will show you the dialog box of format cells. And next shortcut is Control plus 2. This will apply bold format, bold style. So here you can see, here I'm typing 45. When I press Control plus 2, this will affect the bold, and Control plus 3 for italic, and Control plus 4 for underline, and Control plus 5 for strikeout. So we can see 2, 3, 4, 5 all for font styles. I mean, Control 2 becomes bold, that is also we can use Control plus B, and Control 3, that is italic, Control plus I, and Control plus 4, that is underline, that is Control plus U. So we can use the bold, italic, underline, and strikeout by this order numbers 2, 3, 4, 5. And the next one is, that is Control plus 6. This is not a font style, but it hides objects. Those are objects or anything, pictures, charts, or anything. So here you can see, when you click on the insert tab, insert menu, you can see that the picture, online pictures, all are active. When I press Control plus 6, you can see these all options are become unavailable. That means the Control plus 6 is displaced and at the same time hides objects. So when I'm going to press Control plus C here, these are all are active. So to show this how it works, I'm going to insert a new picture on this Excel. So go into the insert and select pictures. In the pictures, I'm going to select this Windows image. So I'm going to show it place it in the actual chart. I mean actual sheet. So here the picture I inserted using the picture command. So this is the object to the Excel. So if we want to hide this object from the Excel, not only this one, but also you can also hide charts. But when you want to hide this one, just simply press Control plus 6 to hide the objects. Those are anything, charts, groups, subtotals, anything. We can hide using this Control plus 6 shortcut. When you press again Control plus 6, this will unhide the images or pictures. So this is the simple shortcut for to hide or unhide objects. And the next shortcut is that there is no shortcut for the Control plus 7 in the Excel. So we are going to forward Control plus 8. This is the shortcut which is also hide and displace, but this one is used to hide and display outline symbols. Here I created an outline data that this will be learned about in the later lessons. So here is the outline data which is outlined in the side view. So if you want to hide this side view in your Excel, so simply just press Control plus 8. This will hide the outline, subtotals, groups, data in your Excel. So when you want to unhide, just Control plus 8. This will unhide the outline. So this is the simple shortcut to hide and unhide the outline symbols. Next shortcut is, this is also hiding purpose, but this one is different from another. This one is, we are going to hide rows and columns using simple shortcuts. That one is Control plus 9 to hide rows. So here it hides 3, 4, 5, a fourth row is hidden. And to hide columns, we are going to use Control plus 0. Here J column is hidden. So unfortunately, there is no unhide shortcut to unhide these rows and columns. So we have to just go to the fourth one, select it, and right click on it, and choose unhide to unhide the row and column. And same thing we have to do, select the column and just choose unhide. We are going to the letters, Control plus A, that is select entire sheet. The first we have to notice, if you select a data, when you press Control plus A, it select the data range. So, and then if you want to select the entire worksheet, have to press Control plus A again to select the entire worksheet. So this is a simple shortcut to select entire worksheet and selected data. And next, we all know that Control plus B will give you the bold option. So next, Control plus C, we all know that is a copy option, copy for any letter paste. So then we're going to use Control D, which is fill down option. That means when you type a data in a cell, where if you want to same data from the above cell, just simply press Control plus D to fill down the data. Not only for data, we can also use some text also. You can also use the text, that means anything, text, formulas, values, anything. We can use Ctrl plus D to fill down the data from the above cells. And the next one is Ctrl plus C. That is, give the values to active rows, I mean active columns. This one was a little bit tricky, but here I created a for data. Here you can see this is the in the Excel I am created first name, last name and full name. So here I created this first names and last name. When I go into full name, I want to use first name and last name as a full name in the name column. So I'm going to type John Ken in the first row, and in the next row, when you see Mary Kelly, when it going to type the Mary Kelly, it also showing the remaining parts with the first name and last name already combined in the section. This is called flash fill. This flash fill is, we can learn about this flash fill in the later videos. So here is the flash fill which Excel recognize the above data and the all corresponding column data to give you a suggestions for the next update. So we can use this flash fill to flash fill. Just now I'm going to press enter. Here you can see all the data is entered without typing from the keyboard. So this is called flash fill. We can turn on and turn off by using Ctrl plus C. If you don't see the Ctrl plus C option, if you don't know is it is on or not, we can check this by going to the file menu, and in the file menu going to the options. In the options you can see in the advanced here automatically flash fill is enabled. If you press Ctrl E, this will disable. So this is the flash fill option which can useful for the taking data from the adjacent columns and without typing any from the keyboard. So next one is Ctrl plus F. We all know that Ctrl plus F is going to the find option. So and Ctrl plus G is going to the replace option. I mean Ctrl plus G is also go to the option, go to find. These are the oldest Excel shortcuts for the finding and going to the rows, columns, pages, etc. And in the Ctrl plus H means it is also replace one, but it shows us the replace tab. So Ctrl F means find tab is active, Ctrl H means replace tab is active. So these are the simple shortcuts Ctrl plus F, G, H are for used for find and replace and go to options. And the next one is Ctrl plus I, that is italic, we already know that. And next one is Ctrl K, that is used for insert hyperlinks. So if there is the empty cell, when you press Ctrl plus K, it asks us to insert hyperlink. If there is a hyperlink is there, main, I'm going to type www.youtube.com. So I created an hyperlink. Sorry, I am going to create a hyperlink. Just I created a hyperlink. So when you select this cell, when you press Ctrl plus K, it shows us the edit hyperlink option. If there is an empty cell, when you pressing Ctrl plus K, it asks us to insert hyperlink. So K means inserting or editing hyperlink problem. So this one used by Ctrl plus K. And the next one is Ctrl plus L. Ctrl plus L and Ctrl plus T are both same shortcuts for creating table. So I'm going to press Ctrl plus L, it shows us the create table option. And if you can also use Ctrl plus T to create a table option from shortcut menu. So Ctrl plus L and Ctrl plus T are used for the table, creating table option in Excel. So and next Ctrl plus N, we all know that creating new worksheet. And next Ctrl plus O, opening workbook. And Ctrl plus P, we all know that Ctrl plus P, it is used for the printer option analysis. There is Ctrl plus Q. Ctrl plus Q is not active when you're using an empty cell. You have to select the data first. This one not a tough one, it is just simple one used for funding, like this formatting, charts, totals, subtotals, tables, sparklines. This is the quick access menu we can use by Ctrl plus Q. We can also use this simple method by right clicking on the, I mean selecting this little box icon. Here when you're selecting this, the icon will be pop up, you can see this option. This one is usable by the Ctrl plus Q. And the next one, Ctrl plus R. The Ctrl plus R, which works like Ctrl plus D, but this will works as fill right option. I mean, it is Ctrl D means fill down and Ctrl plus R means fill right. So I'm going to type my name here. So when I'm going to press Ctrl plus R, it will fills the right side column data to here. So Ctrl plus R fills right, and Ctrl plus S used for the saving option. We all know that. And Ctrl plus T, already told you, Ctrl plus L and T are create table. Next one is Ctrl plus V. Ctrl plus V is a general oldest one for pasting purpose. So this one I already copied from the Ctrl C option in the starting. So this is pasted using here. So Ctrl plus V used for the paste purpose. And the Ctrl plus W is used for the closing workbook. Ctrl plus Y is redo. And Ctrl plus Z is undo. So here these are the all control shortcuts using in useful in Excel. So there are two shortcuts are missing. That one is Ctrl plus J and Ctrl plus M. Technically, there is no shortcuts assigned to these two letters, I mean J and M in the Excel. Ctrl J and Ctrl M are given blank. We can use in the macros or any other customizable assigned shortcuts. Thank you.